This is a tutorial of Des Traynor's Guide Towards Prioritised Productivity Template in Coda. Stop letting everyone else control your time. This template walks through Des Traynor's productivity system, which is based on this tweet that he tweeted on June 26, 2019, when you scroll down in the intro section. And he said, "Thinking about productivity and its tools. Your email is what others think you should work on. Your to-do list is what you think you should work on. Your calendar is usually what you actually work on. How much do they overlap in your world?" And he shows a nice Venn diagram of these three different systems, which you probably use a lot if you work in an office environment. And so the goal of this tweet is to simply put all of his to-dos onto his calendar so that he's not bouncing between a to-do list, a calendar, and email. And so that's exactly what this template does. So let's walk you through how you can also centralize all of your to-dos, email, and calendar all into your calendar to run your week and be more productive. So the first thing you're going to do is set up your to-do list. This is a basic to-do list in Coda. It's a table with three columns, and all you need to do is click on this button right here, add to do, and I can say create marketing plan. I want to do this today. Click outside, and you're going to see that this gets added to your to-do list for today. Now, this is kind of the heart of your productivity plan. So make sure you have an updated to-do list with all your to-dos that you want to work on either this week or today. Then you move on to sync your email. And this is a special type of table in Coda called a Gmail packs table. And remember, people send you emails when these are things that they think you should be working on. And so I'm going to go ahead and sync my email account. And I think I may have to, let's actually add, yep, I have to connect an account first. I'm going to click on this account, finish installing, and let's hit sync now. And this will bring in the last 7 days of email that I've labeled as starred in my Gmail inbox. So I have three email messages in my Gmail inbox that I have starred, and you can see the subject line of the email right in this table here. And you can also see the recipients of that email thread. If you hover over the thread ship, you can see more information about that email, but for now, all we care about is just seeing the thread of that email in this nice table. So once I've synced in my Gmail threads, I can now sync in my Google Calendar. Let's go over here, and same thing here. This is just some dummy data. I'm going to go over here and connect my Google Calendar account, which is this one. Hit sync now. This is going to sync the last 7 and next 7 days on my Google Calendar. So let's see what calendar events I have on my Google Calendar. It's loading events, and there we go. We have these 7 events. Some are duplicate, like weekly kickoff, because they happen multiple times. And I also have some attendees that don't show up here because none of these events have attendees on my Google Calendar. And these are just events coming from my Google Calendar right here. So I've set up my to-do list. I've set up my email. I've set up my calendar into this nice table. Now I can actually run my productivity system by first going through my email inbox and adding any of these emails to my to-do list if they're not already on my list. So new candidate resumes for account manager role. I think I have a related to-do here. I think it's read resumes. Review design for marketing plan. I don't think that's on my to-do list yet. Let's take a look. Oh, no, it's create marketing plan. But update your slides and management deck. I don't believe that is on my to-do list yet. So I'm going to click on this add to-do button. And what that does is it adds that Gmail message as a to-do list item on my list. You can see how it says new to-do from email, update your slides and management deck. And if you go back to your to-do list on step 1 here, you're going to see that it shows up right there. But we'll take a look at that in a bit. So I've cleared my inbox of all to-dos. Now let's go to my calendar. Now this gets a little more interesting. So I have these three items that I have on my to-do list, and I can either link these to-dos to a Google Calendar event that's on my Google Calendar. Let's take a look if there's anything related to a marketing plan. I have a marketing meeting. I think that's, I remember I have to do this. This to-do is related to this Google Calendar event, so I know that's taken care of. That gets filtered out. But this finance update, quota Q2, quota V2 for next quarter, I don't think there's a related finance Google Calendar event. So I'm gonna go ahead and create this event. So I'm gonna call this, let's say, September 10th at 10 a.m. And I'm gonna click on new calendar event, connect my account beforehand. And it went ahead and created a Google Calendar event. You don't see anything right now, but it went behind the scenes and created a Google Calendar event on September 10th. Let's take a look at my calendar right there. Finance update, quota V2. Now, I also want to create an event for this to-do item that I got from my Gmail account. Update your slides in Management Deck. Let's say I want to do this for 9/12/19 at 3 p.m. Click on new calendar event and just double check. I'm going to make sure that it shows up on September 12th at 3 p.m., which is right there. New to do from email, update your slides in Management Deck. And this is a the classic calendar layout of your to-do lists. This is actually a calendar layout of your Google Calendar table. And you notice how my two items I added from here don't show up on this calendar yet. And that's because after I added those events, I have to resync my calendar in Coda to match up with my Google Calendar. So notice how there's only two events for this week. I'm going to go ahead and click on the sync icon, and those two events now will show up on my calendar right here. Finance update quota, and then also new to do from email, update your slides and Management Deck. So this is the same exact view that you would see in Google Calendar, but now I don't have to bounce between Google Calendar and Coda. I can see it all in one place. And finally, I can now run my week in a much more efficient way because I have my entire to-do list. I can see all my to-dos and if there's any linked Google Calendar events or Gmail threads. Remember how I created a to-do item from this Gmail message? And finally, I can see, I'm gonna move this right here really quick. I can now see all my to-dos, all my calendar events in a nice table format. And this to-do list is all my calendar events, whether they came from a new to-do that I scheduled on my Google Calendar, or they came from an existing to-do, or they were already existing on my Google Calendar, but now I have all my to-dos on my calendar and it's all synced between my Coda account and also with Google Calendar. And so you can see how things like this is something I wanted to work on today, which I added to my Thursday calendar for 11 a.m. Finally, when you reflect on your week, you can see that all your to-dos that have been linked with a Google Calendar event are in orange, and all these things in blue are to-dos that don't have a linked Google Calendar event. And so this week is not looking good for me because I have a lot of to-dos that are on my list that don't have an associated Google Calendar event, which means I may not find the right time to do that to-do. And so the goal is to get your entire week to basically be all orange because you have all your to-dos that are mapped to a Google Calendar event. And that's how you do Dez's guide towards prioritized productivity.